What's up, y'all? Today, I would like to cover a topic that I'm extremely passionate about. That would be cover bands, tribute bands, whatever you want to call them. You're playing in a band with other musicians, and you're not writing songs. You're just playing everybody else's songs, and most of the time, not actually acquiring the rights to play everybody else's songs. And this is something a lot of people like to do. They like to fill their set with all their favorite songs from their childhood, from their youth. Honestly, if a lot of these guys were paying for the rights to these songs, they would not be able to justify and afford what they do, paying their band members. I don't think that would be possible, because you have to continually acquire the rights to play other people's music for money. That's what keeps guys like Michael Jackson and Earth, Wind, and Fire paid, is when people cover their songs, they're supposed to pay a stipend to the artist. And by not doing that, you're kind of almost plagiarizing, which, I guess you can do it, but it's, in my opinion, sort of cheating. I'm a big fan of write your own songs, play your own songs, play your own music, sell your own CDs. I mean, because really, if you think about it, you're playing a show and you're promoting everybody else's music. You're selling their records for them, almost kind of passing it off as your own material. If you think of it in a business sense, and how do you make money? Cover band versus playing your own material. In a cover band, we've already discussed the ways that can limit your income in that sense. But if you're playing your own music, you have way more opportunities to make way more money. So if, say, you have your website, you have your online store set up, you have your donate button set up, you've got your merchant accounts, your PayPal accounts, what have you. You play your show, that's an opportunity to promote your website. That's an opportunity to make a sale. And also to get that person's email address when they make that sale and add it to your arsenal of emails, so that you can continually retarget these people in your fan base with email blasts and newsletters and updates about your upcoming performances. And so not only does that make it easier to sell tickets down the road, but then these people are also being moved by your performance, by your song, and they feel like they're getting something special, something unique, something that came from you. You're not copying, you're not imitating, you're being yourself, your real authentic self as a musician, as an artist, as a singer. And so in my opinion, I wouldn't say never play a cover song, but I would say that play cover songs as a means to an end. You know, make your money in your agency bands, your wedding bands, your tribute bands. Then at some point, you need to be writing your own material. You need to be selling your own music. You need to be running your musical life as a business if you want to actually make it sustainable and really change people's lives and get real fans, instead of just piggybacking off of everybody else's fans. You're kind of not really putting the work in at that point. So let's talk about a couple of positive aspects to playing in cover bands. First of all, you're going to learn all the great songs and all of the great artists in your genre. And you're also going to be more familiar with the scene that cover band is involved in. So for instance, here in DC, we have a big R&B, go-go, funk, hip-hop type music scene. So a lot of the bands in this area are just covering music in those genres, and they're very successful at it. And you will learn a lot about that style of music, and you'll learn a lot about, again, the great artists, the people who have really changed that style of music, who really affected, who really impacted that scene. So for example, guys like Chuck Brown in the go-go world, and over here on the East Coast, Biggie Smalls in the hip-hop world, bands such as Parliament Funkadelic in the funk world. You're going to learn all of the great pinnacles of that genre, which is great. But again, if you're not paying these guys for the rights, you're kind of stealing their songs. Another positive aspect to playing in cover bands is it sort of teaches you how to be a professional in a band. It teaches you how to dress appropriately for a gig, teaches you how to show up on time, work well with other musicians, make sure that your rehearsal is running productively and smoothly. So these are all different skills that you'll pick up when you're working with cover bands, tribute bands. You can't ignore that stuff. That's great, and it's a great experience. And I would have to say the same thing about, say, sideman-type gigs and touring, joining other great artists on their gigs, playing their songs. That's fine. That's great. Great experience. Getting out on the road, sleeping in terrible, cheap hotel rooms, and traveling every night of the week and not sleeping very much. And so, yeah, it can be a cool experience. It can be fun. It's like going on a road trip, I suppose. But if you want to make the big money in the music business, you got to be writing songs. You just got to do it. Start with a lyric, get a piece of paper, just write whatever comes to mind. Doesn't matter what it is. Could be total garbage. And I guarantee you, if you do 20, 30, 40 of those, by number 41, you're probably going to have something that resembles a pretty decent song. So I would definitely recommend doing that. Get started, put something down, put the pencil to the paper, and do that. It will transform the way you think about music in general. It will make it way easier for you to learn songs if you are still playing in cover bands to supplement your income. I still say that writing your own songs will make you better at that as well. So we've discussed the pros and cons of playing in cover bands. We've discussed the pros of writing songs, because there's really no cons to that. I mean, I guess you've lost a little bit of time. It's going to take you some time to write a bunch of crappy songs before you get good at writing songs, sure. But is that really a con? Because you're getting a skill out of it. You're getting an invaluable experience that probably 1% of the people on the planet have actually had. Put yourself in that 1%. Go above and beyond. Do something artistically for yourself instead of always figuring out how to prop everybody else up, how to make everybody else's money, how to make all of their dreams come true. Do something for yourself. That's how you get the money.